Welcome back. The Trump administration's new plan to grow the Navy fleet includes hundreds of unmanned vehicles with a variety of capacities. The new Biden administration can and likely will change that plan, though. Captain Jerry Hendrix, U.S. Navy, retired as vice president of the Telemus Group. He's former director of the Naval History and Heritage Command and author of the new book, To Provide and Maintain a Navy, Why Naval Primacy is America's First Best Strategy. Jerry, welcome. It's good to see you. This new plan that the administration has put out, the Trump administration, what difference does it make with less than 3 weeks to go?
Well, it makes as much difference as, quite frankly, the Obama plan that was put out on December the 16th, 2016, with just some 5 weeks to go in that administration, where they enunciated that we needed 355 ships. And that plan and that number has become the touchstone of all of our conversations, essentially, for the last 4 years. And so I think that the Trump plan that tries to get us to 355 within 10 years and 400 within 20 is simply another reference point that highlights the idea that we need a larger Navy. And that's actually what I have been writing about with this new book, is trying to get at the reasons why we need a new Navy, to get beyond just the numbers, because that those number arguments haven't been getting a lot of traction. So I wanted to get to policymakers as well as the broader American people as to why a Navy is important to our country. It gets to the idea of our foundational Enlightenment ideas about the free sea and freedom for individuals. It gets beyond that to understanding how our Navy has maintained oceanic peace for the last 70 years and how that's at risk now as both China and Russia are seeking to close the seas. And so I wanted to get into this conversation and really keep the momentum going as we move into the Biden administration and the policies of the next 4 years.
This is a continuation, though, of the writing and speaking and the conversations that you and I have had for a decade or longer, Jerry. Where are you now on what that new Navy should look like? What's the capacity, I guess, first, and what should it be able to do before we think about what the pieces are that make it able to do that?
Well, I mean, the new Navy, as we build forward, and one of the things I say in the book is that if the Navy in 2040 looks like the Navy we have today, then we've essentially failed. Because obviously technology is moving along, the strategic environment is changing. There are things that we're going to need to change. And clearly one of the ideas that's coming along very quickly and as is represented in the Trump plan is the idea of unmanned platforms, using unmanned vehicles to extend the sensor range of our manned ships, as well as perhaps giving additional magazine depth by having unmanned ships carrying additional weapons, missiles, et cetera, along with them in order to deepen the magazine and sustain the force in the fight. And so obviously we want to see those changes both in the surface force and in the air element, as well as in the subsurface domain, because quite frankly, the 297 ships today are simply not even close to what we need in order to maintain the peace on a day-to-day basis, and then as well as have the capacity to win a war if things really go bad between us and China or Russia.
There's activity in a theater of operations that you and I have discussed for pretty much the entire time that you and I have been discussing anything, Jerry, and that's the South China Sea. Some FON ops happening there in the last several weeks, and also reports that China is starting to extend some of the work. They're back at work, basically, in some of the islands that they have established bases. How does that inform the way that you're thinking about what the new Navy looks like? And how should that inform the way the Biden administration starts to think about where the Navy is and what the Navy does?
It's important to understand that the deployment of Navy ships and the types of ships that we send to key regions represents a form of language between nations. I'm telling you one thing when I send a carrier strike group. I'm telling you something differently when I send perhaps a surface action group that's around a cruiser. And it's something different than if I'm sending a frigate through. All of these things are sort of different levels of a conversation. We are in a heavy argument with the Chinese right now in the South China Sea because they are trying to extend a territorial claim over those waters. They're trying to claim that essentially the South China Sea is internal waters to China. And that's simply not acceptable if we are going to uphold the concept of the free sea. I might add, by the way, that Russia is doing the same thing in the Arctic, where they're trying to reorder their baselines based upon some offshore islands, as well as putting some missiles and armaments out there in order to extend a sovereign claim over the Arctic Ocean. And that's something that we in the West, if we want to maintain free sea, free trade, and the transmittal of free ideas, we cannot allow that to happen. I would say that it's kind of interesting because we've been doing these FONOPs in the South China Sea. That's a very important conversation. But I would also highlight the fact that we sent an Ohio-class guided missile submarine on the surface into the Arabian Gulf last week, escorted by two Ticonderoga-class cruisers, in a very clear conversation that we were having with Iran, that now is not the time, as we sort of approach the anniversary of the death of Soleimani, now is not the time for them to jump ugly with the United States.
We have just a minute or so left, Jerry. You were the first person to explain to me the concept of the high-low mix. Where is that concept right now?
Well, it's beginning to mature, specifically now that we have the Constellation-class frigate selected and we're beginning to build that. We're looking to build no less than 20 of those, but in actuality, we need around 60, a number I call for in my new book. But also with the idea of creating these new unmanned surface platforms to extend the range of ships like the Constellation frigate and make sure that we're covering a greater presence in the ocean. These ships at the low end of the mix, these ships are there to do the maintain the peace aspect of the Navy's mission, while we continue to focus on building our aircraft carriers and our submarines to do the win the war portion of the Navy's role in the world.
Jerry, thanks very much for joining me. Congratulations on the book.
Thank you, and it's good to see you again.